In this video, we'll see how we can relink media in Mistika. And first of all, we're going to see how does offline media look in Mistika. And you can see that in the record monitor output here, we see a checkerboard. And if I play or move around, I see all that checkerboard all throughout, okay, because I move my media. Another symptom that is easy to spot is that we don't have an active frame. The active frame is loaded every time that Mistika finds the media. So in this case, as it can't locate it, there is no active frame. So how can we solve this? So we're going to go to media, and in media, we could press this icon here, or we could go to edit and go to relink, where we could see that it has the same icon as the previous button. We'll press relink, and that opens the relink window. And in the relink window, we find the path of the old location, and now we need to find the new location. I'm going to close the split window option, because what I'm going to do is find the media here in my browser. I'm going to go to source media, because it's where I've placed it now. And there we could see the group of files, folders, okay, and in this case it's C001. Pretty easy to spot. It's loading them. Okay, we could see it's collapsed. It's a single file. And as it's selected, as soon as it got into that folder, the field of the new location is filled up. And now you just have to hit perform. You have the option of doing this in only the clips without media. In this case, all our media is offline, or forcing it into all the clips. We're only going to do it to the media that is offline. We'll hit perform. Mistika is going to advise you and ask you that it's going to replace one path for the other, and you're going to say, yes, I'm okay with that. And at the end, it will advise you and say all clips in the current timeline were successfully relinked. If not, Mistika would have told you how many of them were unsuccessfully relinked. In this case, everything is relinked and we're good to go.